but he believes it's their right for us to be able to protect those rights for them. And for that, I commend him. I think he's just a fantastic person.
Yay.
And if we selected him as a judge, he'd be awesome at it. I'm very proud of this.
Yay.
Yes, I live more than he did. Guys, once again, I'm Sonny Palacios. For those of you who don't know me, I guess most everybody here is. We've had lunch together. We've talked with each other. Sometimes we've been on the same side of the races. Sometimes we've been on different sides of the races. One of the things, though, while we're here, is that we are in an opportunity right now to pick a new district judge. Let us not lose focus of why we're picking a new district judge. Unfortunately, our judge, loved by many, but he got himself into trouble. Resigned respectfully, which I believe was the right thing to do, and it left the precinct chairs with an obligation now, a duty, a right, a responsibility to pick the next district judge who's going to be on the ballot for November. Now, everybody asked me this question of why, Sonny, did you wait so late to come into the race? And like I tell everybody, whoever's asked that one question, I always answer the same way. About a year ago, Orlando Jimenez came up to me and said, hey, Sonny, will you support me? I know you have people that you talk to during the congressional race. You have people that you talk to during your school board races. So and people like you. I said, well, I don't know about too many people liking me, but I'll talk to people. I happen to know a lot of people. So I did, and I was out there petitioning for him. I was out there pulling for him. And then one day he tells me I'm not running, and, well, okay. So I looked at the pool of candidates. I have the deepest respect for Judge Macias. I have the deepest respect for Ted Lopez. And I have the deepest respect for Mr. Godinez. I admire their policies. I admire their stances. But I got in this race because I realized I have something more to offer, not just from the public policy position that I've been on the school board, but even in what is happening here with the school, with the benches here in Dallas County. I wanted to make sure that people had a voice on a lot of the issues that I found near and dear to my heart. Because in my 16 years of law practice and, you know, doing indigent defense in all those years and then doing all fighting special education cases, fighting for LGBTQ rights in these counties, it's been tough to get a fair shake, whether it had been for my daughter Suzanne for one reason or another, or my cousins or friends or whoever. It's tough to get a fair shake. The Valley, unfortunately, still is very conservative. That's the truth.
Bless you.
It is very conservative. And as much as we want to say we have Democratic judges, and I'm not knocking other Democratic judges, I like their position. We do have some courts that are forward-thinking, moving into the modern trends. I felt like I still have something a little more to offer. So I threw my name in the hat. I threw my name in the hat as an exploration committee on a Thursday. By that Monday, I walked in the courtroom and, oh my God, you're running. And this is what started out as an exploration turned out into an explosion. And that's the way it's been since then. We've been running hard, running fast, meeting everybody. I've been meeting people that said, you know, Sonny, I know the family, and I was siding with this person, I was siding with that person, I was leaning here, leaning there. But after I talk to you, I cannot in good faith vote that way. I like you. We need you. We need someone fresh. We need someone good. We need some of this. So when we're looking at the 93rd bench, we need somebody who's going to have the power to keep this a Democratic stronghold. We need to keep this a Democratic stronghold. Everybody says, oh, well, a Republican will never win down here. Well, if we play it safe like that, or we play it loose like that, it may happen. It can happen. There's a base that's swinging. It's swinging silent. There's a silent majority. It happened in the nation, and we saw the effects in the nation. One of the reasons why we are sheltered here is because we are a Democratic stronghold, and we want to keep it as a Democratic stronghold. So there's three things that we need to look for when it comes to your next candidate, your next nominee, your nominee for the 93rd. Three things. A strong base. And that's one of the things we've shown historically. We've supported strong candidates. We've been there. We've created a movement. We've gone out walking the streets, shaking hands. The grassroots movement is true to our family, true to our friends. Once you're in this family, once you're with us, we're family, right, Chano? We're family. You cannot separate us. That's who we are. And we come together as a group of family. And that's how we do. So we want to make sure we have people that's a base. Second is you need to make sure you have people with the resources to help pull other strong Democrats forward, to help pull other modern new Democrats forward, to help push a what we call progressives, start moving forward in this direction. Start moving forward with these new ideologies. Start moving forward, and let's not be 20 years behind the rest of the United States anymore. There's no reason why we have to. That's the same ideology I had on ECISB, which then turned, in just a matter of 2-3 years, turned ECISB into the Texas Outstanding School District of the Year, Texas School Board of the Year, all for recognition for looking at things so simple as equality. Equality in education, equality in funding, equality in opportunity, whether it be gender, gender identity, gender space, whatever. Just making sure that this person had the same rights as this person, that this person had the same opportunity as this person. And I was sitting on the board asking myself, we're here in 2010, 2012, and I'm still fighting these issues. We shouldn't be fighting these things anymore. So that's the second thing. The third thing is where we want to go, name recognition. And when I look at it, there's only two candidates, possible candidates and nominees in this thing that have name recognition, the base and the funding to move forward. So the question you got to ask when you look at those two candidates are, do you want to move backwards or do you want to move forwards? If you want to move backwards, by all means, do that. But expect more of the same. But if you want to move forward, then I invite you, let's move forward together. That's all we've been doing. Let's move forward together. Because when it's, like I said it before, and I'll say it again, this is not about me. It's never been about me. It's been about us. But we cannot, I said it when I first ran for Congress, on that first night where I announced everybody, we can change the world, we can change things, we can move forward. But we gotta do it together. We have to do it together. And so I invite you, talk to your friends, talk to your family, talk to everyone. Let's change this. Let's change things down here in Dow County for the better. Let's change it though, together. And that's right here. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Sonny Blossoms, seeking the nomination, but I can't do this without you.
Yes! Woo! Yeah!